Hello friends, and how are you all today? My name is Priyanka and the question says, integrate the following rational functions. Now here the function which is given to us is 1 upon x into x raised to the power n plus 1. Now, when we are dealing with trigonometric functions, it is always good to see if the numerator in the fraction can be obtained by differentiating a component in the denominator. We know that derivative of x raised to the power n is n into x raised to the power n minus 1. So multiplying the numerator and denominator by n into x raised to the power n minus 1, we get one upon x into x raised to the power n plus 1 is equal to n into x raised to the power n minus 1 upon n into x raised to the power n minus 1 into x raised to the power n minus 1, plus 1. Now, integrating both the sides, we get integral of 1 upon x into x raised to the power n plus 1 dx is equal to integral of n into x raised to the power n minus 1 upon n. Now, x raised to the power n minus 1, when gets multiplied by x, we will have the answer as x raised to the power n into x raised to the power n plus 1 into dx. Now, the numerator, that is n into x raised to the power n minus 1, is clearly the derivative of the component x raised to the power n in the denominator. So, put x raised to the power n equal to t, and therefore, differentiating both the sides, we will have n into x raised to the power n minus 1 dx is equal to dt, right? So, the above fraction will become one upon n into one upon t plus 1 dt. Now, one upon n will be a constant, so taking the constant out of the integral, we have 1 upon n integral 1 upon t plus 1 dt. Now, 1 upon t plus 1 can be solved by using partial fraction method. So, we have, now, let us solve it by using partial fraction method separately. So, we have 1 upon t plus 1 can be written as a upon t plus b upon t plus 1. Now, taking LCM, we have, and equating the numerator is equal to a, 1 is equal to a into t plus 1 plus b into t. So, we have, on equating the constants, so it will be equal to a, that is equal to 1. And on equating the coefficients of t, we have a plus b equal to 0. Since the value of a is 1, so the value of b will be equal to minus 1, isn't it? So we can write this as 1 upon n integral. The value of a was obtained to be 1, so it will be 1 upon t plus the value of b was minus 1 upon t plus 1 into dt. Now, taking integration sign separately with each term, we have 1 upon n integral 1 upon t dt minus 1 upon n integral 1 upon t plus 1 dt, that is equal to 1 upon n log mod t minus 1 upon n log t plus 1. So it can be also written as 1 upon n log t upon t plus 1 plus c. Now, substituting the value of t as x raised to the power 1, we have 1 upon n log x raised to the power n divided by x raised to the power n plus 1 plus c. And this was the required answer to this session. Hope you enjoyed and understood the whole concept well. Have a nice day ahead.